Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video we are going to talk about use effect and use reducer hook. Okay, so these are like not a very good combination, but you can use it. Like in use reducer, when you wanted to fetch some data, then you can use effect hook to get the data and then set that data in a particular state. So this is the previous example. What I will do here in this example is I will just set the data. So consider that my initial state is array, okay, and this is my reducer. What this reducer is doing, it is just checking update. Simple action is update I'm triggering, and what update will do is update will update the state object with new property. So in the state we have this new property data, so it will update the data with action.data which we are receiving. We don't have any other actions, so we can just remove them for now. Okay, simple reducer we have, and this reducer we are passing in the use reducer, form reducer, and initial state. Initial state is data empty array. Now what you can do is you can write use effect hook here, and use effect hook can be used to fetch the data and set the data in the particular state. Here what we are returning is null for the cleanup, because we are not doing any additional thing here. Here we can make axios.get a request to a particular URL, and dot then we are getting some data, and we will set the data to our state. So here we already know what is the state, so we have to call dispatch with the action type. So we have two things, type is update, and here if you go to hook this reducer function, we are getting the data from action, or you can call it as a payload. Okay, so here we need to send one other property data, and we are also getting the data property only from the response. So you can actually do it like response.data. Here we are getting response. So this is how we can actually update the state object. So use effect will hook will trigger first. This is some kind of API call you are making. Okay, get a data or something like this. Okay, once you see the data, you are actually updating the state inside use reducer. This state will be propagated to your child component, because here we are using use context. I mean, we are creating provider and consumer. Here we are using in child component, we are using use context in this form component. So you can say this example is actually using three different hooks: use reducer, use context, and use state. You can have one more like use state also you can use. So use reducer, use context, and use effect we are using, and this is one time call only. Once this call triggers, we are actually updating the state with the data, and that data then being passed to child component. Okay, so these kind of examples we can talk about. In the next video, let's talk about use reference hook, which is also another important hook to do the DOM manipulations, all these things on the UI side.